It's the fourth such conference in a series, and I think the World Bank is to be commended for pulling together actors, not least the cities of India, because that's where the action has to take place, obviously. So if we can help link Indian cities and those responsible for taking decisions, moving towards smarter solutions within the framework of the governments of India's larger policy framework of smart cities, enabling these cities, linking them with companies, of course. At the end of the day, it's not a bad thing if new and emerging technologies are put to good use. We have been working towards both the Millennium and now the Sustainable Development Goals, trying to implement making cities, making living conditions more sustainable. Looking at it from the outside, sometimes it's difficult to know exactly how the process is moved forward. Who is in charge of what? Where are the budgets? Who makes the decisions? City councils? How does it tie in with the national aspirations, the national plans? Who do you actually engage in trying to move the ball, so to speak, to use an analogy, a sports analogy? And that's not always crystal clear. It can be a little opaque. It's a new initiative, so that's not unusual or strange in and of itself. But I think that is a challenge. If the parameters and the way forward could be made more clear, a timetable, decision framework, etc. It also varies between states and cities, I believe. Governments of Sweden and India have a joint innovation partnership, a strategic partnership for moving innovative solutions forward. We've set aside a fund and some seed money for this. The idea is to have it matched on the Indian side. This is going towards various solutions in order to finance startups, test hubs, tie-ups between Swedish and Indian companies to co-create and to come up with new solutions that can be implemented, hopefully also creating employment in the process. Coming from the outside, partnering with companies, cities, etc. here, to have as much light shed on this particular way forward, the practicalities of linking up, the decision frameworks, timetables, etc. That, I think, is a challenge, but one that can be overcome quite obviously. And having a conference like this, getting those various parties together is a very good step. There's this Nordic innovation setup. They're centered in Oslo. It's financed jointly. And we can speak partly individually, but also partially through them. Companies in the Nordic countries, in Sweden and elsewhere, can link up through Nordic innovation and have one avenue, a broader avenue, to access partners and potential partners here in India. We know a thing or two about working in India and conditions here. Ericsson, again, is, of course, in communications, 5G rollout. They are a very important player, potentially, in setting up the framework for intelligent solutions that rely on parts speaking, so to speak, communicating with each other. And if you build from there, you know, the sky's the limit.